This is a public service announcement brought to you by Self-Critic. I apologize for switching the audio quality midway through the stream. My microphone really let me down. I guess I'll need to invest in a new one. Welcome to Self-Critic Reviews, and today Self-Critic is gonna review King Iso's new song, Odysseus, from his new project. As usual, before I begin, my opinion on King Iso. I think he's a very talented rapper and unbelievably impressive with keeping up with his rhyme schemes. At times I'm actually shocked at how long he can go using the same one. Often it doesn't even last one verse. It could last the whole song. And I don't know how he does it. The delivery of his lines is very apt and strong, although it could be monotonous. But with that said, his flow creativity at times suffers a lot, as he doesn't switch it up. And if he picks a boring pattern, it can ruin the whole material for me. Just like most people, I know King Iso because of Tech 9, and as you can guess, I'm a Tech 9 fan. But not necessarily a Strange Music fan. But that's probably a story for another time.
These are Self-Critic Reviews on television and news. If this in your favorite artist, well, you're not getting amused. This is Self-Critic Reviews.
If this gonna get different clothes, or if it's on YouTube, yet he is getting no views.
If you want some unbiased opinions, an analytic mind is worth billions. Yet he has been hiding his brilliance underneath this stifling indifference. And if you don't like his opinions, go look for like-minded civilians to whine in the comment section and slap a dislike on his videos.
I decided to review this because it's surprisingly a very impressive song, and instantly shot King Iso up to be the second best artist on Strange Music. This song has Tech 9 written all over it. And I'll be honest, if Tech 9 wrote this song with the same lyrics, same flow, same delivery, I'd be singing praises right now and telling how it's a classic and listening to it on repeat and showing the song to everybody, etc., etc. The singing section, both the chorus and the verse slash bridge, sounds solid. Maybe his voice isn't as good as Tech's, Stevie Stone's, or Chris Calico's, but it works in my opinion. And the vocal structure is quite good too. And vocal structures to me are more important than the voice itself. It's an unpopular opinion, but hey, if a good voice is singing something with a terrible structure, it's really boring to me. While the reverse would be a lot more interesting. That's why I actually like rap. The patterns, the syllable structures, geometry. Now, the lyrical theme about suicide is engaging. King Iso succeeds to bring his point home about paradoxical suicidal thoughts. How he wants to kill himself, but also doesn't want to kill himself at the same time. How he wants to kill just a part of him that he hates and not all of him. It's all cool and understandable, but I do believe that the lyrics themselves are a bit suspicious at times. And this is what we're going to discuss in depth now, namely the rap verse. So the whole verse, again, has Tech 9 written all over it. Tech definitely did not ghostwrite it, but I do strongly believe that Tech specifically asked him to follow the 4-bar rule, meaning to switch up the flow every 4 bars, or 8 bars in this particular case, because it's a double time flow, and 8 bars are perceived like 4 in double time if you didn't know. And this tutelage worked wonders, so thanks to Tech 9.
Pressure builds, I can't blame my peers. I look in the mirror just to face my fears. Most deaf need support, can aim not here. When your criteria is you can't cry tears.
Okay, so these 4 bars are actually pretty good. I especially like when he says, when your criteria is you can't cry tears. Great word choice.
Tears that will I am to go shake my spear. Face to face with the king gave my leer.
Okay, I recognize these genius.com lyrics could be wrong. And if they are, please let me know. I won't repeat it the second time, but this goes for every single line on the song. Just leave a comment and tell me what he's saying, or what I didn't get. Alright, so these lines. That will I am that go shake my spear. what does he want to say here? That will I am, that go shake my spear? Is this English?
That will I am to go shake my spear. That will I am to go shake my spear. That will I am to go shake my spear.
Genius.com says it's spear, not spear. But I think it's spear, although neither makes sense to me. So the second line, face to face with the king, gave my Lear. It's a wordplay because King Lear is a character in Shakespeare's tragedy, King Lear. And that's also why it's spear, not sphere. Because shake my spear, Shakespeare, get it? And also Lear, L-E-E-R, refers to the gaze, the look. The problem is, aside from the fact that it's a bunch of wordplay, these words make zero sense together. And that's not how wordplay is supposed to work. Okay, if I wanted to force it, he's probably saying that King Iso is shaking a spear against the king and giving him an angry look. So these are abstract lyrics that he probably wants us to figure out and give meaning to when there is none. Next.
Blush, yeah, the Van Gogh, I gave my ear, now I'm mutant shapeshift to change my gears.
So yeah, he's continuing that battle with King, quote unquote. Of course, he mentions Van Gogh and a missing ear. Never heard that before. I mean, he probably wrote these three rhymes first. Shake my spear, gave my Lear, and gave my ear. And now he's thinking, oh my god, so what do I do? Alright, so for the first time I have like shake my spear, so I'm referring to Shakespeare. So that means that the second line, gave my Lear, huh, so there is King Lear, so I gotta mention a king. Oh, and the third line, so what did I do there? Huh, gave my ear. That's easy. Van Gogh! Van Gogh! Yes! Yes! Easy! Yes! 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 We're done! Yes! Alright, so good for him. But now I'm mutant shapeshift to change my gears is actually not too bad.
And made me a monster that stays right here. A prison inside me, I gave my ears.
First off, this is the first switch. It's not necessarily the flow that changed, but his delivery change is just as effective. And I like his singing voice here. As for the lyrics, yes, he mutant shapeshifted and became a monster. Continuity. That's good. Verse writing 101.
The villain is toxic, how I waste my beer.
This is forced, but not too bad. Considering your beer more valuable than you, is definitely in the vein of a suicidal person.
My demons are locked in, the safe not near.
This is even more forced. First off, the sentence structure is too broken for the English language. I know nobody cares, but locked in the safe not near? Maybe it's not that ridiculous in terms of sentence structure, but still kinda dubious. But locked in a safe? Isn't being locked in a safe a good thing? Safe isn't necessarily an item that invokes some kind of heartbreak or sorrow. And wouldn't demons being locked in a safe be a good thing? They are locked and cannot get out, so isn't it like the opposite of what King Iso actually wants to say? Probably.
How can I drive straight and face thy rear?
The usage of thy is so Tech Nine. And admittedly, I always think it's lame when people use this word for a rhyme scheme. This word is too archaic. My rule is, if you want to use it, don't. Find a new way to say what you want to say. But as far as the meaning goes, how can he drive straight and face the other person's back? I don't know. Easy? Just drive straight and follow it? Like, what's the problem? What's he saying here?
If you ever I've been, they say I'm here. Off in the dark where my day's not clear. To face the music and play by ear.
I think the first line is totally wrong. I think he says veered, not feared. and I cannot understand the first line, so I'm not even gonna make fun of it. But yes, using the word odd is in spirit of Tech N9ne. If of course King Iso even used it here. The second line is fine. Quite flat, but fine. And the third line is as well, but not sure what music he's referring to. Listen, every pussy they repeatedly feeding me, got me needing my greenery and I drank my beer. Okay, so now we're getting to the good parts. And by that I mean the funniest parts with the most ridiculous phrasing. Got me needing my greenery. What's he talking about? Weed? Money? Both? And repeating the word beer for the second time in a verse? Just kidding, that's okay. These demons be leaving me and I think of deleting me, but it's something that people cling to and save like here. Think of deleting me? Think of deleting me. Oh my god. Wow, that's the worst and most pathetic way I've ever seen somebody refer to suicidal thoughts in lyrics. That's so whack. Wow. The second line is good, right up until the point when he says, like here, for the rhyme scheme. Because yes, saying that beer and weed is something that people cling to in order to save themselves from suicide is actually true, and it's almost a great line. But it had to be ruined by like here, a very unprofessional way of ending a good line. For me, that's an evil deed, and I think that I need to be ridding me of an evil me. I'll erase my smear. Even though it also does sound kind of backwards here, I think it works in this specific line. I need to be ridding me of an evil me. So I approve. But erase my smear is hilarious. I'll erase my smear. Yeah, it's really off kilter and not in a good way. All over the scene, I need my Jyoti to speak to me and my
son and these on me because I ain't Nazir. Yeah. Okay, this is a message from post production. I'm too lazy to make a video, but I just realized what King Iso is saying. It's actually not GOG, but GOD, which means that the reference to Nas is through that word, because Nas is God's son, and King Iso is saying that he ain't Nazir, so makes sense. But I'll still show you what I actually said in the video.
Okay, so I know this line is 100% wrong, but I don't actually know what he really says. Nasir obviously refers to Nas, but I can't place what he's referring to. So, not gonna make fun of this line. A song for the misfits, light a blunt, get a bong, take a quick hit. If you got your alcohol, take a quick sip. We don't wanna be gone from existence. Wait. Did you just hear that? Light a blunt, get a bong, take a quick hit. If you got your alcohol, take a quick sip. Yes, this. Take a quick sip. What kind of terrible engineering is this? This lip smacking sound is one of the worst sounds in human history. And I even remove it in these reviews specifically because I know how annoying it can be to listen to. I refuse to believe that engineers don't think this sound should not be removed. And it's not the only time this sound is not muted. And honestly, it's really unprofessional. But lyrically, it stopped being roundabout and now the word choice is normal. So that's good. The flow is, however, not. But up until to this point, the flow has been amazing. Especially if the flow with those ridiculous lyrics I made fun of. So don't think I hate this because of his lyrics. Flow is good and that's good enough for me. Just erasing the part that is within. Kamikaze in part, maybe with it. I don't know, just the thought that I sit with. Suicide dog, call it dishes. Cause I never wanted to heal myself.
Yeah, great lyrics and a great end to a verse. You probably noticed it, but Odysseus is suicide spelled backwards. So in a way, this song is meant to be a revival of sorts. And it's good to send a positive message like that. So yeah, I finished making fun of King Iso, but I do believe it's a great song. And it takes a special track for me to actually decide to review it seriously, without giving it any kind of free pass. Imagine if I reviewed all my songs this way. I guess it's good that I'm not a popular YouTuber, for artists' sakes. As a side note, I think his singing lyrics are actually better than his rapping lyrics. So definitely credit where it's due.
There's no tourniquet available, a bandage that will make it go. It's seeping through my pores until I drown. It's unescapable to stay. Getting hard to breathe. Suffocated by anxiety and who I do not try to be. Who the hell lied to me? Cause I don't think that I could be free. When the doctor said speak, I said I never wanted to kill myself.
I think it's impressive. Just good word choice, imagery, etc., etc. Thanks for watching.